you use your system today, everywhere we are talking about iCloud. Microsoft has something called OneDrive, Google has something called Google Drive. What is this cloud computing? Because if you look at business enterprises, there are lot of initiatives to put everything on a cloud. So, what do we mean by this cloud computing? So, in the first part of this session, we will understand some basic definitions of cloud computing. We will understand what cloud can offer, why do we need a cloud, and what are the challenges from a security point of view. It actually turns out that one of the major challenges today in providing a cloud computing infrastructure, whatever it means, is the security. Now, we will also see some notions of where security brings a big issue, where security becomes a big issue when we look at cloud. So, this session we will talk about cloud computing in more detail. So, we go with this, what is the definition of cloud computing, what is the architecture of a cloud, what are the benefits of having a cloud computing infrastructure, and what are the opportunities you get by moving on to a cloud computing. In the next session, we will talk about what are the challenges in implementing a cloud infrastructure. So, these are all definitions of a cloud. Many people have come out with cloud. For example, Gartner says a style of computing in which massively scalable IT related capabilities are provided as a service using internet technologies to multiple external customers. So, and there are many other definitions which are almost equivalent to this, but with some different nuances and colors. So, basically a cloud is one infrastructure which can cater to the need of many people and do different varieties of services. So, it has different functionalities and it can have different types of services, in the sense it can store for you, it can compute for you, right, and importantly it can scale to your need. So, today your business is say x, tomorrow it becomes 2x, then this cloud can scale. So, this is what we mean by the basic definition of a cloud. Essentially means a provision of an infrastructure which is scalable and which can do varieties of services for you. There are other interesting definitions of cloud. For example, cloud computing is using the internet to access someone else's software running on someone else's hardware in someone else's data center. So, this is a very nice, very interesting definition. Essentially, it says you need not care, all that you want is provided, and you really need not bother who is running the software and which hardware this software is running and where this hardware and software combination is located. So, it becomes completely independent of everything. You get a service and what you need is a basic internet connection. This is a very nice definition of a cloud computing. There are other definitions which becomes a little more technical, wherein people talk about a cloud as a large scale distributed computing paradigm. And important word here, again it talks about scalable management, etcetera, but another important thing is what you call as a virtualization. What do you mean by virtualization? What is virtual mean? What does virtual, the word virtual mean? As far as you are concerned, you look at one very big system and think that it is serving you. Actually, it may be serving many people. You only look at your part, and for you that server is says that I am giving you a service, whatever service you want. You really do not know what is internal to that server. You just see a machine, a black box which does all the functionality you want. So, all the implementation, everything is hidden from you, and that is why this word virtualization comes there. So, as far as you are concerned, you see one holistic server which is entirely, and you feel that it is entirely dedicated to serve you, but in reality it may be serving many people, but as far as you are concerned, it is a dedicated server for you, and this is what the term virtualization means. Now, so we had some basic introduction to the definition of what a cloud is. Now, we will see the architecture of a cloud. How is a cloud built? What are the important components of a cloud? When we look at cloud architecture, we actually need to see three important things. How do you think the cloud is going to service you? So, that is what we call as a cloud service model. And how is this cloud being deployed, the cloud deployment model, and what are all the characteristics of you want from this. So, when I want to arrive at an architecture for a cloud, I should basically have a basic, I should have an understanding of what are the services it is going to provide, what type of services it is going to provide, and how do you go and deploy this infrastructure that can provide you this service, and what do you expect from them as a characteristics. So, all these three parameters essentially give out an architecture, define an architecture. Now, just based on these three parameters, namely characteristics, service and deployment, the entire cloud architecture can be viewed as shown in the slide. This is the NIST visual model of cloud computing definition. So, there are certain essential characteristics like what we call as broad network access, rapid elasticity, measured services, on-demand self-services and resource pooling. These are all some essential characteristics that we expect from the cloud. We will go and discuss about each of these characteristics in great detail in this session. We are also looking at several service models for this cloud. What I expect from a cloud? I want the entire software environment on the cloud. That is what you call as SaaS, service as a software as a service. The next model would be, I do not need the software, but I need platforms in which I could build the software. For example, I may need JBoss, I may need a Linux, I may need the operating system, I may need development tools like compilers, etcetera. So, this type of, and I will develop software on that. This model is called PaaS, which is platform as a service. I do not need anything, I just need the hardware, then this basically becomes an IaaS or infrastructure as a service. I need the compute hardware, I need the networking hardware, and possibly some firmware on top of it which will boot, right. So, these are all the three service models. And these, on these service models, I would like to have realized those characteristics that we have mentioned above it. And then there are several deployment models, at least four deployment models, a public model, public deployment model, a private deployment model, a community deployment model, and probably a combination of these three, which is called the hybrid deployment model. So, to sum up this slide, an architecture of a cloud can be well defined based on three important parameters: the deployment models, the service models, and then the essential characteristics. Now, we will go and define every label that we have put in every box here or in detail as a part of this session. Essential characteristics. We have talked of several essential characteristics, in which one is on-demand self-service. Cloud is an infrastructure which is massively scalable. The moment I am talking of scalability, one of the important thing that comes in mind that should be ensured is lack of human intervention. I need to do some activity, it should be automatically done by the system. So, one of the thing that cloud should offer, if at all it becomes scalable, it needs to become scalable, is to give this on-demand self-service, wherein a consumer, if he wants some service, he should be able to invoke that service whenever he needs it. That is why the adjective on-demand, and he needs to invoke it by himself without relying on some other human interaction. and that is why we call it as self service. So, this is one very important essential characteristic of a cloud environment and which essentially makes it scalable. From a scalability point of view, this is very important. The next one is broad network access. What do you mean by a broad network access? Essentially, it means that my access is not limited by the end device. For example, I need to have a cloud that I can access from a laptop, I can access from a mobile phone, I can access from a tablet, a phablet or any PDAs, and it should also be accessible from a desktop or a server, etcetera. So, some sense of universality in terms of access to the infrastructure is necessary. So, that is what we mean by a broad network access. The next one is of course, resource pooling. We will talk about resource pooling in much great detail when we proceed in this session, and one such model for resource pooling is called the multi-tenant model. But today the most important thing is that multiple consumers are using the cloud, and if you say suppose a million consumers want to use your cloud. For example, let us talk about Gmail. There are millions of users. I could view this Gmail as a cloud because it provides a service for millions of users. Can I have million servers, one each for it? Can I have million hard disks? No. So, we essentially need to go and share the resources, pool the resources, and so whenever a so Gmail is just one very small application, but when you look at cloud, we would give some user applications where say for example, we could have a VLSI cloud for making chips. So, there will be several companies who can come into this cloud and run processes, run programs that will go on for days together. So, we are looking at having one set of resources and dynamically assign and free release it from different programs or processes which want to use these resources, and this is what we mean by resource pooling. Another most important thing is this rapid elasticity. So, what is elastic? So, when I stretch it stretches, when I release it basically comes back to a shrink and size, it shrinks and expands as desired. And we need this rapid elasticity. Essentially, it means that when a customer wants lot of resources, he should be rapidly able to give him those resources. And the moment he does not need, we should be in a position to immediately withdraw and reassign to someone. So, this sort of an elasticity need to be built inside a cloud, so that on demand the user actually gets as much resources that he wants, and the moment he does not want, it can be shrunk and it can be given to others, it can be released and given to others. So, elasticity is another important characteristics of cloud, and we use this word rapid because the user should never feel a lack of resources. It is from here, if suppose you are a cloud service provider, it is very important that you keep your customers satisfied. The customer should never feel that there is a lack of resources, and that means the moment he asks for a resource, the program that he runs asks for a resource, it should be provided. And from your point of view, you need not, you will not be willing to keep a resource with a process when it does not need. So, you should quickly pull it out. So, this quick response is captured by that adjective rapid. So, this is another characteristics of the cloud. The other thing is cloud cannot be given free, you have to run the cloud. As a cloud service provider, I need revenue. So, there should be a very nice and transparent way of controlling this cloud, controlling and optimizing the resource usage, and you should also have a clear metering capability at some level of abstraction for your service. How much amount of CPU I am using, how much amount of disk I should use, how much amount of memory I am using, how much amount of network I am using. So, all these resource usage should be monitored, controlled and reported, and importantly that it should be very, very transparent, right. So, when you make a call, then immediately an SMS comes saying this is the duration that you have spoken and this is the amount I have removed from your balance. So, this is a measured example of a measured service, but measured service should not be that. It should, one important point that you should note in this particular slide is the measured service should not be a nuisance, right. So, for every half a minute I do not want a message saying yeah, you have done this, that will clog your network, right. So, I need to have sort of a summary of my usage. I am just talking about a mobile phone usage in this. So, there should be some abstraction in which you go and measure your service that you have provided. What should I measure itself is a very, very important debate. The moment I go and measure everything, then again your entire cloud service would be more on the measuring end rather than servicing end. So, these are some very important characteristics that we need to keep in mind. Now, we will look at cloud service models. There are three service models, as I told you. One is the software as a service, another is platform as a service, another is cloud infrastructure as a service. We will talk about this SPI model in some detail here. I have actually explained this. An infrastructure as a service essentially means that we will provide the processing capabilities like CPUs, the storage networks and other fundamental computing resources. So, the consumer will be in a position to run arbitrary software, which also includes his own operating system, applications, etcetera. And the computer does not, the consumer will not manage or control the infrastructure, it will be completely controlled by the cloud service provider, but the consumer will have control on the operating systems, the storage, deployed applications, etcetera. And he will also have limited control over the networking components, like how to configure the firewall, for example, etcetera. If I look at platform as a service, the capability provided to the consumer is to deploy the cloud infrastructure plus some things like operating systems, etcetera. Then and say any development tools, like I mentioned JBoss, etcetera. Now the platform can be essentially used for developing your own applications. So, this is platform as a service. For example, you open your website so there are several people who can host your website, that can be termed as a platform as a service. The other thing is the entire software itself as a service. So, we have the entire software, I have some generic workflows. This workflow itself can become a service. So, here the consumer just gives the functionality and it is completely tailor made for the consumer, and he does not do anything. Everything is managed and controlled by the cloud provider. Okay. So, in the next session we will go and talk about the deployment models for cloud. Thank you.